You want to tune vocals in Melodyne? I'm going to show you how in Melodyne 5. You'll know exactly how to get insanely polished vocal tracks by the end of this Melodyne tutorial. Hey, it's Andy from Studio Hustlers. Before you tune vocals in Melodyne, go grab my free course on music production. One of the sections in that course shows you how to build and prep your vocal tracks before you tune them. We call it the Producer Secrets mini course. It's gonna make your song sound awesome and your singer sound like a star. There's a link in the description. It's free down below, go get it. In full transparency, Celemony did see my last video on Melodyne, and they liked it and they wanted me to make one on Melodyne 5. I use Melodyne no matter what. This program's pretty nuts. So let's jump into Logic today. We're gonna tune these two vocals in Melodyne. For context, here's what this sounds like untuned.
Me and you down in Bermuda. Behind the dunes in the afternoon. Me and you down in Bermuda. Me and you down in Bermuda.
All right, so decent vocal tracks. They're pretty pitchy though, so we're gonna fix that. First thing we're gonna do is go to this regular vocal track, and we're just gonna use Melodyne as the first insert. So put it before compressors and all that type of stuff. I'm gonna grab Melodyne Aura, which you can do in Logic. If you are using Pro Tools, you'll have a transfer button somewhere up here. You click that and then have to play the audio to bring it into Melodyne. If you're using Logic or using a DAW that has Aura, you can literally just click
me and you down in Bermuda.
And then it's in here. So that's insanely fast. One of the only things that I think Logic is actually faster than Pro Tools on. But here we have our vocal track. So it's in here. If your vocals are in a straight line when you bring them in, come up here to the algorithm and just change it to melodic, and then you will have the melody of your vocal. So we're looking at a few things here. We have these blobs of audio. We have these lines, and then we have these parts right here where it's these little vertical lines on the blobs of audio. So the blobs, that just means there's audio there. That is sound. That's your vocal track. The line, that is going to be the vowel sounds, and the line is the pitch of that audio. But then this right here, these little vertical lines, that's actually a consonant sound, like a t, p, ts, one of those sounds that doesn't have a pitch to it. In previous versions of Melodyne, you used to have to chop these off because you can't tune that, and then you'd have to tune the vocals here. Melodyne 5, though, they fixed that problem, and this does recognize the consonant. So you actually can just grab this in any fifth generation Melodyne plugin, and you can just come up to the macro slider and just change the pitch, and then you could probably just change the pitch drift too. Boom, it's tuned up. So let's go ahead and just play that.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
Done. So that's how you tune vocals extremely fast in Melodyne. But that's more of an auto-tune approach. This program lets you get way deeper into it. So if you want to change an individual note and fine-tune anything, you just come here to the pitch tool and grab this. And you can basically drag this note wherever you want it to go. I like it right here.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
So if you notice this last note over here, this pitch is kind of all over the place, and it does sound a little bit weird.
Bermuda.
It's a little bit flat too, but I want to make that more consistent sounding, so we're actually going to grab the pitch modulation tool. You just hold your mouse up here, click pitch modulation, and we can drag this to straighten it out, or we can make it more crazy. If you go up, it'll go more crazy. I want to make it more consistent. So we're going to put it like that. Let's take a listen to that.
Bermuda.
Now it focuses just on this main pitch here a little bit more instead of fluctuating so much. You could also use it over here too, but this pitch is a little bit more consistently off. It's not going back and forth so much. So this one, you actually want to use the pitch drift tool because the pitch is drifting away from the note that I want it to be on.
In ye. In ye.
And there we go. Now it's more consistently on that note here. So let's take a listen to this.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
That is mostly what you need to know. Like, this is already, in my opinion, better than Antares Auto-Tune. I'm using Melodyne Studio here. So I'm going to go to this star vocal track over here and turn that on as well. We're going to put Melodyne on this again. And then we're going to just click play.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
And it's in there. So it's up here though. Again, I'm using Melodyne Studio. You can actually see all of the tracks that are in here if you want to. I want to use the star vocal, so I'm going to switch over to that one. And then we can actually see your other vocal tracks, you know, behind it. I have this lead vocal track right here. Let's actually grab the whole thing. And then we're going to go ahead and just tune this with these sliders here. Let's see what that got us.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
Okay, I want to mute this one, though, for right now.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
I mean, that sounds better already. Let's go ahead and just take this pitch drift tool and clean this. Get that all in the same thing right here.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
So on this vocal here, one thing we could do is mess with the timing a little bit too. It's already tuned up because we just did that. If you grab this tool right here, you can actually drag the notes around. This is probably going to sound pretty crazy here, but let's just see what it sounds like.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
Yeah, it did sound terrible, but just for tutorial's sake, just showing that if your singer's a little bit off on the timing, you can, you know, get really, really specific with it and change the timing of the vocals right there. So the big thing you would use this for to make your vocal tracks sound awesome is to record a ton of doubled vocal tracks and then match up the timings perfectly. So you'll have like 10 vocals that are all perfectly timed up. It'll sound like one vocal that's just extremely thick. That's basically what Justin Bieber and Katy Perry and Ariana Grande and them, I mean, they're awesome singers as it is, but when you stack up the doubles there and make it sound really thick, that superstar sound, that's how you get that. So let's actually show you what I'm talking about. I'm just gonna grab one of these other vocals. All right, and we have our vocal here. This is the one that we brought in. So as you can see, I have the main chorus vocal in orange. That's the one that we were working on already, but you can then see the doubled vocal also on the same track. And I actually already, you know, tuned this up, so it kind of is already directly on the other notes, but this is what I'm talking about. If your vocal comes in like that, you know, it looks kind of a little bit off, just come in here with your doubled vocals and match up, you know, the length so they're like perfect on there, okay? And what you'll end up with is basically this sound. I already tuned these vocals here, but Melodyne will actually give you this vocal sound, which is huge. Let's listen to just the vocals by themselves.
Muta. Behind the dunes in the afternoon, me and you are down in Bermuda. Me and you are down in Bermuda.
For context in the whole track, is what it sounds like with all these vocals tuned and timed up using those exact techniques that we just went through. I just spent a little bit more time fine tuning things.
Me and you down in Bermuda.
So that's how you tune vocals in Melodyne to get a really polished sound and how to make your vocalist sound like a star. That was me singing. I'm an average singer at best, if you ask me, but that sounded really good, I thought, and it's mostly Melodyne. So if you don't have Melodyne, I would go get it. They're not telling me to say that. I really do think it is a must-have tool, and it's the coolest one in my arsenal, to be honest. They do have some pretty cool tips on their Instagram page, so I'd go give Celemony a follow. Otherwise, I will see you inside the free Producer Secrets mini course. The link's in the description down below. Go get that. See ya.